Okay, hi everyone. In case you haven't seen me before, I am Tanya. I form part of WeConnect, the Health and Fitness. And today I decided to give you a little bit something different. It's going to be a 30-minute workout on an indoor spinning bike, okay? It can be a normal bike. However, the workout is going to be also good if you have a treadmill at home or if you have an air walker. I know some people have this equipment at home and they hardly use it. So I decided to do a 30-minute workout so you can actually go on that machine and do yourself a good workout. Okay, hope you enjoy it. Okay, and we get started. Please always remember that it's an interval training type of class. Workout, sorry, I'm so used to saying class. it's a workout. And so if you're feeling a little bit under the weather, please avoid it, okay? Just keep it steady, endurance, okay? But if you're feeling okay, you can do this workout, no problem, okay? So because you're gonna be bringing the heart rate up quite a bit, okay? So I will explain to you as we go along, okay? So please remember, if you have a treadmill, I will explain to you how to increase the intensity and when you need to lower it, okay? So, ready to go and enjoy. I'm gonna start with the music. Okay, like everything else, you're gonna start with a warm up. So if you're on the bike, you need to relax your shoulders. You need to keep your feet flat, relax the shoulders and bend the elbows a little bit. Okay? If you're on the treadmill, just start with an easy walk. Okay? Moderate intensity. Two. just a little bit more. Come up to a, what we call a standing flat, up, chest forward. If you're on the rowing machine, just take it up to another one. On the treadmill, keep it as is.
Seconds, everyone.
need a drink, have a quick drink. Please do not get up, just make sure that the water drinks you. Go in a seated climb. If you're on a treadmill, you're gonna go to a climb. So you need to increase your incline. You can do it in a jog or walking uphill. If you're on the rower or the air walker, you need to add your intensity, your resistance. Okay? Okay, let's start adding that resistance. Feel the bike getting harder. More power in your legs, strength, line, you're feeling your incline going up. We're gonna do this for 3 minutes. If you feel the 3 minutes is too much for you, just bring it down and go back to a flat road, okay? Okay, let's start the climb. 3 minutes, push. Relax those shoulders. It. The last minute I'm going to give you a choice whether you wish to keep the same resistance or add more to make it more intense. One minute past. Push. Right and left, right and left. Strong pedal stroke. If you're on the treadmill, use those arms. If you're on the air walker, strong arm movements. The climb, that heart rate is going to go up again. You're building up. One more minute to go. Now it's up to you if you wish to add a bit more resistance to make it more intense or keep it as is. Recover. 5 seconds. Release. flat row. Keep those legs moving. Keep the arms moving. Just take a quick breather. And you're going to go back to that climb. But this time, you're on the bike. It's going to be a standing climb. The others will do exactly the same thing. That's recovery.
Recovery. Nice. Let's go
Okay, just a little bit. When I turn it down. You go into a sprint, make sure you have enough resistance, make sure you are not bouncing on the bike. Make sure you have the right incline for the, and the right speed on the treadmill. It's up to you, up to your training. Are you ready? 30 seconds. Starting now. Go, pick up, sprint. Push. And use your breathing. When you're recovering on the treadmill, you can walk or easy jog. Get ready, everybody. Go, second sprint, pick up. Push. This is where your heart rate has to go up. The ball in the right zone, the red zone. Sorry. seconds each one and 20 seconds recovery in between. Okay, so you're gonna have very little recovery. I remind you, do what you can, what you feel doing. If you feel you can't do the 20 seconds and 20 seconds recovery because they're too close, too intense, take it at your own pace. Keep it flexible for now. They're going to be back to back, seated and standing. So the others are going to have four intervals. Staying same with just 20 second recovery. Get ready. 20 seconds and we'll have our first sprint. Seated, a bit of resistance for control. Get ready. Everybody, go, pick up, sprint. 20 seconds, push. Slow it down. 20 second recovery. keep it going. Easy. We're gonna start the cool down. Now, if you don't, since this is just 30 minutes, for some it might be enough. It can be an express workout, you don't have much time. So, this is just enough for you, and you're gonna go on to something else, or else you're going to decide to do a little bit more of another workout. It could be weights, it could be abs. So, but very important, if you decide to stop, this is enough for you, you need to stretch straight after this workout. If you're gonna continue with something else, you make sure you stretch after the workout you're going to do, okay? So if you feel that your heart rate is back down to normal, for the ones who are very fit, this is gonna happen very quickly. It takes seconds. If you are not so fit, it might take you a few minutes, okay? So you need to take it at your own pace. When you feel that you are totally ready to get off the bike, you come to a stop, you slowly get off the bike, and you, or else you get off the other machines you are using, and we'll do a stretch. Okay, this is super important, please. A lot of people decide, off the bike, bye-bye, good day, I will see you next time. Please, always finish off with a stretch. Okay, so would you bend the knees? I hope you can see me properly. Bend the knees. I think that was better over here. Bend the knees. Okay, head between the arms and hold the stretch to stretch your lower back. Always hold the stretch for at least 15 seconds. And slowly come up. Take your right leg either behind the bike, okay, or by the side, or just take it forward. Or just take it behind. You're gonna stretch the calf, the back part of your foot, the lower part, and make sure the heel is down to the floor. The same leg, you take it forward for the hamstring stretch, lifting the toes up front, or placing it on the lower part of the bike or on the treadmill or on the front part of the rowing machine. Take the same leg on the opposite knee. Okay? Imagine you're sitting on a low stool and hold the stretch this way. Take the same leg behind, stretch the quad, the knees together. A lot of people do the stretch like this of the quad, the knees are far away, apart. Then the knees must be touching each other and chest upright. And change leg, calf stretch, heel down to the floor, upper body bringing it forward to feel the stretch. Hamstring, you bring the same leg forward, lifting the toes up. Place it on the opposite leg. Bringing it down. Another important stretch is for the hip flexor. Okay, so you're gonna take the same one leg behind, you bring the hips forward and hold the stretch. This is very important, especially when you cycle, even if you cycle outdoors, The hip flexor stretch is very important. And change. Bring that leg in, you take a deep breath in and exhale. Ladies, gentlemen, I hope you enjoyed this workout, 30 minutes. I hope if you have equipment at home and it's full of clothes, remove those clothes and do this workout. Thank you and hope to see you soon. Bye bye.